despite record low inflation and low interest rates, starting a new business in the wake of the economic crash can be extremely difficult.
Bathroom Takeaway was an idea that we came across about 5.5 years ago. The business plan was written for it at that time, but the worldwide financial crash and the recession wasn't the ideal time to start it. Banks weren't prepared to lend, so Bathroom Takeaway, whilst we showed the business plan to a number of banks, we actually couldn't get any support from any banks at all. All of the investment, which is now nearly £8 million in Bathroom Takeaway and working capital, stock and so on, has all come from private investors.
Company Managing Director Julian Smith started in the trade as a WTS trainee at 16 years old. He has used those 27 years of experience to create a unique business model within the bathroom industry.
The inspiration for the business model, I guess, is Aldi. I think their supply chain, speed of product turnover, and their connection with their core customers is exactly what we're trying to emulate here at Bathroom Takeaway.
The process we use, obviously, we have to get the goods intake into our warehouse first. Then the products go to marketing, which they will take photos of, then put them onto our website, then to be sold to the general public. So if the company says, we get intake, we get products here on a Monday, we want them on the website on a Thursday, we have to set procedures up to make that happen.
As a result, the company has seen month-on-month growth of over 20% since it began trading in December 2014. However, with such rapid expansion comes fresh challenges.
If you look at staffing alone, we've gone from 11 staff at the end of last year. We're now at 34, I think, at the last count, and we'll probably hit Christmas somewhere around the 36, 37 mark.
We've had to expand and we've had to adapt our systems to the way the products have been coming into the business, where we're storing the products, how the products are stored. It's been very challenging, on the other hand, it's been a great experience.
In addition to its financial successes, Bathroom Takeaway was also given a Bronze Investor in People Award for its work within the Manchester community.
This weekend we're going to do SOS Bathroom. So we're going to do a new bathroom for a young carer and his parents. So we're taking them this weekend to Central Park, and then while they're there we're going to do a new bathroom. So it's organising all that.
In terms of charity work, it comes down to wanting to give something back, and what are the core values of the business. And actually it's fantastic for our staff to be involved in things like that, and actually very important to put something back into the area.
Bathroom Takeaway are set to expand into Europe, with Julian Smith undeterred by the upcoming in-out referendum.
The EU and the UK are pretty much wedded together. We don't want to be part of the political argument, and I think the UK is a massive trading partner and the door swings both ways. So I'm not overly concerned about the referendum. We can't influence it, so we're going to focus on what we can do.
Julian Smith knows that the country still faces financial problems, but he is confident that Bathroom Takeaway will continue to thrive. Joe Toms Ashcroft, That's Manchester.
My name is Russell Feingold. I'm a charity manager here at Key 103's Cash for Kids. And tonight we're really proud, in partnership with Bathroom Takeaway,